Hello, I am Mist C. Laneous from
Still
Europe.
No!
Oh my god, Dub! I didn't even get through the full intro line!
Sucks for you, then.
Okay, that's it. Get out of my house! Leave! Now!
Fine! I'm glad to get out of this dumb place.
Well, Art, I guess you're our only cynical jerk now.
Yes, I'm so fortunate.
Sorry about that. I'm Mist C. Laneous, reviewer of The Miscellaneous, and the time has come yet again to look at the new musicals I saw last year and decide on which one was the best. Let's take a look. As always, here are the rules. Rule number one, it has to be a musical. Rule number two, it has to be a show I did not see live, work on, or experience in its entirety until 2015. Rule number three, if I only saw a movie or a filmed performance, it doesn't count. Like last year, I'm gonna try a non-chronological approach. It seemed to work okay, except this time, I'm gonna get the short and awkward ones out of the way first so I don't have to deal with them anymore. So, that said, lots of fun, excellent music and comedy. Not bad, I guess. Kinda, and some good dancing, though. Now, the ones that I don't have a lot to say about, but I'd still like to discuss a little more. For instance, Kiss of the Spider-Woman. A groundbreaking new production about Julie Taymor and the interesting choices she made while putting on the Spider-Man musical.
Excuse me! Kiss of the Spider-Woman is about two inmates in a Latin prison. It has nothing to do with Spider-Man.
Art, it's called a joke.
Yes, hilarious. I'm going to burst my lungs from laughing so hard. Ha ha ha!
Saints have nothing on you. This is actually one I've wanted to see for a while, so it's cool to finally cross it off the bucket list. Had some good music and kinda interesting subject matter. I don't know if I'd say it really stuck with me, but at least I didn't dislike it, right? Ooh, I just thought of another show I got to cross off the bucket list in 2015. A funny thing happened on the way to the forum. I'll try saying that three times fast. Funny thing happened on the way to the forum, funny thing happened on the way to the forum, a funny thing happened on the way to the forum, See? You can't do it. Gotta admit, it started out a bit slow, but it did pick up after a little while. After that, it's an enjoyable little farce. I do get the feeling it's one of those quality depends on the production shows, but it's not as much of one as, say, Guys and Dolls. I think the script has a better chance of holding up on its own. I mean, it's more like the production really needs to have good energy and timing and things like that. Like I said, one of my rules is that I need to have seen the show in its entirety in person. So, like, if I saw a condensed version, that won't count. I can't talk about it. Like, say, Jekyll and Hyde. I've seen a full production of it now, so now I can talk about it. It's okay. The music's pretty decent, though the only real standouts are the group numbers. All three of them, and maybe Once Upon a Dream, not that one, and of course the climactic confrontation. But there is one little thing that kinda plagues the show. Just about every single song in this show seems to last forever. It's not as much of an issue in the more exciting numbers, but the 4-minute ballads can get a little tiring. Again, this might be a bit of a production-reliant show. I could see winding up as really thrilling or really boring.
Mist, who are you to judge? Have you seen these shows multiple times from various companies? Mere speculation is not a solid thesis to go off of!
Art, did you forget that this is Best New Musicals? I haven't exactly had that opportunity.
Precisely my point! Your argument is as effective as a tortoise in a chocolate factory assembly line!
Don't let him get you, Miss. Just think of a show you really liked! Ah, excellent choice! Okay, remember last year when I talked about All Shook Up? Well, it turns out Nice Work If You Can Get It has the same author. Only instead of Elvis music in a 1950s Twelfth Night Footloose story thing, this is Gershwin music in a 1920s Prohibition era story thing. Yeah, so that pedigree had me pretty intrigued. And seeing this show, I pretty much just got all shook up again. But I love All Shook Up. Maybe it's not exactly the greatest show ever written, and maybe not the most in-depth characters, and maybe it shares a lot of traits with Zolshoka, but despite that, it's still a night of hilarious fun. And I do have to admit, I wonder if I might not have liked it as much if I wasn't already an Zolshoka fan. And I went in with pre-established connections and expectations, maybe there was some sort of bias in there, but as someone with that bias, my desires were certainly appeased. I cannot wait until this show's available for licensing because, my god, I need to be in it someday! As long as we're on the subject about musicals that use pre-existing music, let's talk about Motown the Musical. Now, I enjoyed the show alright when I saw it, but afterwards, I read some things online about how it may not be all that great. And I can't lie, they've got some decent points. The main guy isn't that flawed or complex, the story doesn't have that many big hardships, famous groups are indistinguishable, it's more of a glorified concert of moments from Motown songs and doesn't really talk that much about how it played into racial issues at the time. And with that in mind, I definitely feel a little conflicted. Perhaps it's not all that strong, yes, but like I said, it worked okay for me. But as someone not all that in the know of Motown songs and artists, it wasn't as effective for me as it probably was for those who were. Because holy crap, this was one of the most into-it audiences I've encountered as a theater-goer. Lots of applause, cheers, big laughs, they were loving it! Meanwhile, I'm just sitting there all, yeah, nice show. But if it makes any difference, I was under the weather when I went, so maybe I'd have been more energized if I was feeling better?
You went to a show sick!
I wasn't at my sickest. I think. Besides, the only part where I got concerned was when Diana Ross had the audience join hands for Reach Out and Touch Somebody's Hand.
You didn't.
It was that or looked like some jackass stick in the mud.
Congratulations, Mist! You infected 3,000 old people!
I only held two hands!
It would have spread, would it not?
Across four levels of seating?
I can't speak from experience. I've never gone to a show sick!
Moving on! Let's talk a bit about Mary Poppins. Why must it be so hard to adapt this story? Okay, let's go back in time a bit. Disney makes a Mary Poppins movie and author P.L. Travers hates it. Years later, famous theater producer Cameron Mackintosh is able to get the rights to make a stage version of Mary Poppins, on the condition that only English people can write it and no one from Disney can be directly involved. Then, Disney Theatrical's head Thomas Schumacher starts up a collaboration with Mackintosh so the show can have songs from the Disney movie in it. So, by the mid-2000s, Disney puts out a Mary Poppins musical that takes cues from the movie and the original books, making for a story with its share of similarities to the movie, but a ton of differences. Like, I could do a whole video about the Mary Poppins musical and how it compares to the Disney movie, but I still have some more shows to talk about, so I'll try and keep it more concise. I must say, I would put this among the top three Disney shows I've seen. Probably number three, but still. Interestingly, the classic Disney songs feel shoehorned in. Sure, they're there, but the scenarios tend to be different, and the song's presence begins to seem kind of forced. In fact, the new songs for the show may be a little better. They suit the tone well, and they're pretty nice, despite a cheesy lyric that may pop up in a couple spots. Here's the thing, though. Remember the 1950s Peter Pan musical I mentioned earlier? Sure, there's a good chance you'll be thinking of the Disney movie while you watch, but that's kind of inevitable. And besides, it's not trying to be the Disney movie, it's not being put out by Disney, so it's not all that big a deal. Mary Poppins, however, is partially an adaptation of the Disney movie, and it actually was put out by Disney, so it's totally justified to compare the two. I mean, sure, Mary Poppins tries to err a little more towards the original books, and if you want to make a musical based on just those, cool, that's fine. But this is an official Disney product representing the Disney movie, so we are allowed to say that it may not have been as good in some areas. We can point out why some of these changes to the story actually may not be bad ideas, but we can also point out where the movie was just better. Mr. Banks actually has to deal with a consequence and find joy despite it in the film, But in the musical, he's given a negative consequence, only to later have that consequence revoked and excused. It's nice to see him told that he had made the best choice after all, but it's not quite as meaningful as how the film did it. That kind of thing happens in a couple other spots, too. Like in the musical, during the dreaded walk to the bank, Mr. Banks encounters the bird woman and offers her tuppence.
Hey, bird, sir. I'll take tuppence, okay?
But take it as a great favor if you would kindly feed them for me.
That truly is a really sweet moment, but it just can't compare to the bird woman's haunting absence in the film.
Keep it together, miss! Keep it together!
So you could say that the show's a mixed bag, but as far as mixed bags go, it still was an alright end result. Say, let's continue this streak of magical British females and talk about Matilda the musical.
Forced!
I don't think I'd go as far as to call it amazing, but it was still a good one. Had some great group numbers and side characters, especially the show's true star, Miss Trunchbull.
What about rules, honey? Rules.
Matilda Wormwood is an exception to the rules.
An exception? To the rules? In my school?
But there is something I have to mention that kind of bugged me. So throughout the show, Matilda tells a story she made up about an acrobat and an escape artist that's based on the adults she's dealing with. Fair enough, but then the more it goes on, the more it begins to resemble Miss Honey's backstory that the audience may already know going in. And then it turns out it was Miss Honey's backstory, down to the last detail. What? Miss Honey, where did you get this scarf?
Oh, it belonged to my parents.
Your parents? Miss Honey, your parents weren't an acrobat and an escape artist, were they?
They were.
And did your mother die in a failed super-specific performance routine?
Matilda, please don't!
And did your evil aunt, who are modeled after Miss Trunchbull, come in and abuse you and possibly kill your father?
Aunt Trunchbull!
Jesus Christ! Okay, one more to be sure. Did your mother have a father named Boris who apparently ran away?
Boris!
Really? You just had to sneak in your little reference that not everyone will understand.
Yeah, because you've never done that. Cough, cough, Sweeney Todd jokes in the Barney review. Cough, cough.
Oh, be quiet!
Well, there's only one show left to talk about. Actually, it was the first show I saw in 2015. Like, seriously, I saw it on New Year's Day. And, well, what is this show, you may be asking? That's not what you should be asking. What you should be asking is this.
What are those?
Yep, Kinky Boots! The show that beat Matilda at the Tonys, not only for Best Score, but Best Musical! Probably one of the hottest new shows Broadway has to offer. So of course I had to see it when the inevitable tour came around, and well, my god. I think this was a first, like, this hasn't happened to me before. It's like my life has been changed. I saw Kinky Boots and my view of the world was forever altered. I don't know how to put it. I mean, I don't think I've gone to see a show and come out feeling so...
disappointed!
I mean, wow. The worst show ever made? Probably not that far. A waste of 3 hours? I don't think I'd even say that. But this was far from a good night at the theater. It was so eh that it's saddening. This is what beat Matilda?
Like I said, Matilda might not be the greatest show ever made, and in all fairness, I haven't seen either of the other best musical competitors that year. But between Matilda and Kinky Boots, Matilda is undeniably the superior show. That one had an enjoyable story and characters and music and such. Kinky Boots, on the other hand, didn't really have those things. The story isn't terribly exciting, the characters could be more interesting, or hell, even better written. The main guy, out of nowhere, becomes a dick in the middle of Act 2 for no real reason other than to cause some sort of sudden conflict. And the fiancé, oh my god, the fiancé! She's not even a real character! She's just a plot device! And sure, that can be kind of forgiven if the character's enjoyable and or interesting, but she is not. She's just the stock self-centered fiancé that wants the main guy to be what she wants him to be. She is so horribly written that this is literally her first line.
Charlie, here are the shoes I told you about. Come have a look-see. Aren't they the most necessary things ever? If you want to slip a ring on my finger, you'll first slip these shoes on my feet.
Yeah, that's a real person! And I'm sorry, but I cannot see how this won best score when its opening number is so lazy that it could be the worst song I've heard in a Broadway show.
The most beautiful thing in the world. The most beautiful thing in the world, Charlie, that I know the most beautiful thing in the world. The most beautiful thing in the world, Charlie, it's beautiful.
But hey, it's not like there are any other musicals about tolerance and gay drag queens that Harvey Fierstein wrote the book for that could possibly be superior to Kinky Boots. Oh wait, yeah there is, La Cage aux Folles. A show that was so fantastic, I still debate whether or not I made the right choice in not naming it Best New Musical of 2012. It was so well written and enjoyable and touching. It was one of those performances that I would love to relive. Kinky Boots, on the other hand, I've never been so disappointed in a Broadway touring show before. I was lying in bed that night wondering if I'd be able to enjoy one of these show things again. Wondering if I should keep going to them. God, I just couldn't believe it. And yeah, I'll admit, maybe where I sat played in a little. I was a bit more far away and distant and feeling disconnected, and I like to feel more, well, I like to be not too far, like, so that I can still feel a connection to these people, get that surreal thrill of watching people on stage. Maybe that factored in. It could have. But even then, I would think that the material still needs to hold up on its own, right?
Oh yes, boo-hoo, you didn't have a preferable seat at a Broadway show. You're so unfortunate. All those people dealing with hunger and poverty around the world have nothing compared to your woes. You're the most miserable person on earth! You only have a decent home, people to keep you company, and a YouTube series! Poor you!
Art, can you put these on and come outside, please?
Whatever. I'll still be able to berate you.
You have no understanding of basic intelligence. Your skills as a reviewer...
Why you are so terrible at everything? Like, for instance, why must I be wearing this attire? What difference is it going to make?
Just so your nice clothes don't get too messed up.
What?
Come here, yo!
Well, I'm back from the mall.
Hey, Emperor, guess who's unleashing his ass? Oh, do you want some Tabasco sauce with that?
Where did this chasm come from?
Okay, I think I've gotten most of the blood off my face.
What the hell, man? Why did you kill the entire supporting cast? I don't know. I just got really mad at Art and it kinda snowballed.
Obviously. Hey, in my defense, you only gave me a super bare-bones outline for this episode. Kind of too much free reign, eh? That doesn't mean you were allowed to kick Dub out, and then you killed him too! How did you even do that? Nitrous oxide.
Ugh.
Well, let me ask you a question. Why would you allow me to get so murderously angry to begin with? It was supposed to be for a future review. I'm gonna kill people in a future review? No. No, see, there's gonna be something in an upcoming review that'll piss you off so much you'll wanna hurt someone. But you won't actually do that.
Huh.
But no, you had to go and use it now. Thanks. Do you realize how much this is gonna wreck the channel? This is the end! I can kiss the YouTube left goodbye!
Yeah, I'm the only thing you could possibly do on YouTube.
Well, you're pretty much my most reliable thing at the moment. I mean, let's be real. I'm never gonna get anywhere with that Archibald Snatcher cover album.
Tell me, why are we so blind to see that Lord Portly Rind is a dick? Been spending all their lives under that no good portly rind.
What about the Imagineering channel? Whatever, look. Maybe we can fix this. Really? And how might we do that, Mr. Fix-It? You're still Doc Brown, right? Till April. So why don't you just go back in time and stop this from happening? Of course! I'll save the channel and screw up the timeline in the process! I mean, maybe if there was some way to know exactly how I'd affect the future, then maybe I'd be a little more on board, but don't they have an app for that now? Oh yeah, what do you know? Okay, looks like the only change would be that the video might get uploaded in February instead of January. Better than nothing.
For you,
okay,
then.
Okay, that's it! Get out of my ass now!
Miss, can I speak to you for a minute?
Oh yeah, sure, Rob.
I'm sorry, Dub. You can stay.
Well, I have to admit, it is kinda nice living here.
Well, I guess it's like they say.
Can't live with them, can't live without them.
And that was every new musical I saw in 2015. What do I think?
There's no business like show business like no business I know.
Everything about it is appealing.
Everything that traffic will allow.
Nowhere can you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow.
There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low.
And the best new musical of 2015 is... First Date. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you again in the mist.